Hello there and welcome on Geopolitical Maps. Which block of influence South America countries belong to, West or East? Let's find out. Peru had a very turbulent history during the 20th century, alternating between political crisis, economic crisis and coup d'état. In the recent history, we can trace back a clear foreign influence on the country when Alberto Fujimori got elected president in 1990. Indeed, his office had very close tie with the CIA through the intermediary of Peruvian head of secret service, Vladimiro Montesinos. CIA provided special funding to help silence the far-left communist guerrilla organization, the Sendero Luminoso, or Shining Light in English. Peru also had a strong cooperation with the US to fight the illegal drug trade through the US Embassy International Narcotics and Law Enforcement Office, as the country hosts numerous coca farmers. Peru's stance on international matters is mitigated, but leaning more toward USA alignment. They supported the USA-led coalition regarding the war in Afghanistan in the United Nations, although they not participated directly. They aligned with USA sanctions and condemnation toward Iran and North Korea nuclear activity and recognized Kosovo as USA did. But on the other hand, they didn't participate in the war on terror, neither the Iraq war, and recognized the state of Palestine as the opposite of USA. It is part of the Rio Pact, the Inter-American Treaty of Reciprocal Assistance linked to USA and other American countries that should support each other if any member of the treaty faces an aggression. Peru also participated recently to the RIMPAC 2022 with Colombia, Chile and Ecuador. RIMPAC is a USA-led maritime military training aimed at promoting peace and stability in the Pacific, but is mainly seen as a Chinese deterrent to show what the US and its allies are capable in case of war and instability in this region, around Taiwan and North Korea issue for example, especially since China stopped being invited since 2016. Regarding the economic tie, Peru has a free trade agreement with both the USA and China since 2009 and 2010. But China is by far the main trading partner in terms of export and import, with 28% of total foreign trade, far in front of USA that's its second with 17%. Although the Peruvian ambassador to China recently stated that the current trade agreement with China is becoming obsolete and needed to be modernized with elements related to e-commerce, competition policy, intellectual property and custom procedure. In recent history, it seems that Peru was going to shift towards the Eastern influence bloc following the election of President Pedro Castillo in 2021. Indeed, it hinted at reconciliation with Venezuela and would no longer support USA unilateral sanctions toward it. We also saw Castillo government get closer with Bolivia as Pedro Castillo met several times with Bolivia president Luis Arce to develop their commercial and touristic relationship, as well as fight to the illegal drug trade and illegal mining. But with the impeachment of Castillo in December 22, it seems that its political project will be at a deadlock while the country is currently frozen in an unprecedented political crisis. With all of this in mind, we can classify Peru in the leaning west bloc. Let's now have a look at the southern border of Peru and talk about Chile. The most recent and flagrant influence of USA in Chile was the 1973 coup d'état of General Pinochet. Indeed, declassified transcript of telephone conversation between Henry Kissinger, Secretary of State at the time, and President Nixon shows that Nixon administration directly contributed to creating a coup climate in Chile that led to the 1973 coup d'état. Following the coup, Chile became an economic laboratory when Pinochet government used Chilean economists that studied at Chicago University under the neoliberal economist Milton Friedman. These economists, called the Chicago Boys, advocated and implemented widespread deregulation, privatization, and other free market policy in Chile, furthering the USA ideology and influence on the country. Regarding the international politics, Chile is part, like Peru, of the Rio Pact. It is also part of the OECD, the Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, alongside the main country of the Western Bloc, USA, European Union, the developed country of Asia-Pacific, and even Colombia, that I classified in the Western Bloc in my previous video. Chile even has a visa waiver program with the USA, which means Chilean citizens can travel up to 90 days in USA as tourists without needing to apply to a visitor visa. This reinforces the level of trust and cooperation in the country toward each other. Chile is also a strong ally of the European Union, by being the first country in Latin America to have established diplomatic relations with EU in 1967. Cooperation ranges from political talks, economic deal, climate topics, civil society, and human rights, as well as science and technology. Regarding the economic tie, Chile concluded several free trade agreements during the beginning of the 21st century with the European Union in 2002, USA in 2003, and the first ever in Latin America with China in 2006 under presidency of Michelle Bachelet. We can see that Chile is over-dependent on China that currently represents one-third of its total foreign trade. This is a quite tricky situation, as any geopolitical tension regarding China on the international scene could lead to sanctions and thus jeopardize Chile's ability to sell its abundant natural resources. But on the other hand, if China wants to keep its strategic advantage in lithium refining and electric battery production, it will need to ensure a steady supply of raw materials that Chile and other South American countries can provide it. We can say that the two countries are both dependent on each other to pursue their economic and strategic interests, and thus need to keep a stable relationship, which we will likely feel in the future international stance of the two countries toward each other. More recently, we can note the election of Gabriel Boric, the new leftist Chilean president in 2022, the youngest ever president of Chile at 35 years old. Boric's view on neoliberalism could shift the country ideology and thus the influence of foreign power. He mentioned that if Chile was the cradle of neoliberalism, it will also be its grave. He also expressed his opposition to Israel, a significant ally of USA, at the beginning of its mandate by postponing the accepting of Israeli diplomat credential in September 2022. Only time will tell whether Boric will manage to shift country foreign position to a more neutral stance on the international landscape. For now, given the last 30 years of Chile foreign politics, we can clearly classify Chile as a leaning west in our influence scale. And this concludes for today. If we zoom out, we have now 5 South American countries in the Western Bloc and only one so far in the Eastern Bloc. Please subscribe and like if you enjoy the content. This will be super helpful to help me grow and support the channel. This video was the second of a South America series where I aim to classify all countries of South America in the 2 blocks of influence. So stay tuned for the next one to get the full picture of South America. You can also have a look at my first video on the series if you missed it. Thanks a lot and see you soon.